To calculate hours worked overnight in Excel, you have to do a little extra math. But first, the right time formatting matters. Your start time and end times need to be formatted using a time format with an AM or PM designation. The easiest way to do this is to type the time and follow it with AM or PM. Any lunch breaks or rest periods need to be formatted without the AM or PM designation. You can set this by selecting the cells that you want to format, right-clicking, and in Format Cells, go to the Time category and select any of the options without a PM designation. And then when you type it as you would a time format. So say you want to take a 30-minute break, you would type 0:30. Now this could be a bit confusing because if you go back to the cell and you look up here, it shows an AM designation. However, with the format that we selected, it will calculate correctly. So then all you would normally do is subtract the breaks and the start time from your end times. But as you can see, this gets tricky when you work overnight. The reason for this is that Excel sees time as a decimal between 0 and 0.99, each number representing a fraction of a 24-hour period. And you can see this if I format this to a general format. So the trouble with overnight is that since the decimal number for the AM is less than that of the PM time, when you subtract one from the other, you end up with a negative number. And this negative number is outside the 0 to 0.99 spectrum that makes up what Excel sees as time. We can work around this by using the mod function. So mod stands for modulus, which is a mathematical way of calculating the difference between your number and a divisor. I'll add a link in the notes if you're interested in learning more about the math behind it. But here we can use mod by using one as the divisor. And essentially what it'll do is help us calculate the difference between the negative result and one. So let's delete what's here and we'll type equals mod parentheses and a second parentheses for our calculation, and we'll do the end time minus the start time, close the parentheses, and we'll use 1 as the divisor, and that gives us 0.33. Now don't forget, we still need to take out any breaks, and now that we have this calculation, let's format this again as time. And we see that between 6 p.m. and 2 a.m. minus a half hour break, we worked 7.5 hours. So the reason why you want to use mod if you're tracking night shift hours is that you can also use this formula to calculate any day shift hours worked without affecting the result. Whereas if you just were to subtract 1 to get the inverse, you'd have to remember to update your formula for each instance. Notice if I were to copy this formula to these other line items, the result would be the same. So this gives us total hours, but in time format. Remember that the 7.5 hours is actually 0.3125. So to convert this to a number and help us calculate our total pay, we need to multiply this by 24. So all we do is take the total hours, which is again a fraction of a 24-hour day, and multiply that by 24. And we don't want this formatted as time. So that gives us 7.5 hours. We'll plug in our hourly fee as a dollar sign, and then our total pay will be the hourly fee times the total hours times 24. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.